In my today's lecture on subject engineering mechanics under the topic of analysis of truss, and the method is joint method of joint analysis of truss by method of joint. First of all, we should know what is the truss. What are the types of, what is the truss and what are the types? Truss is this type of member supported at two ends. They are maybe reverse. It can work as a passes, deck, vehicles can be pass on this side, and it's to back. Okay, so the deck is hanging at this. Many variety of the trusses is available. You can go through YouTube, and depending upon the arrangement of the members, they are known by different names. Here, I am discussing the types of the structure on the basis of its analysis. So, we have two type of trusses. First one is perfect truss and second one is imperfect truss. What is the difference between these two? The difference is very simple. This is a simple truss, means a truss can have minimum of three joints, minimum of three members. Minimum joint three, minimum member three. If we add one more joint, then we need two more members. Further, with the addition of further node, we need two more members. Further, if I am adding, we need two more members. So, it means number of members for this type of arrangement, it can be calculated by 2j minus 3. Required number of member for having this type of geometry. What is the geometry? This is triangulated type of geometry. We need 2j minus 3. Okay, in case of three joint member, we will have three. In case of four, we will have 4, 8, 5. If joint is 5, then we will have 7, 6, 9. Two member being added. Okay, so in this geometry, what I want to tell you, in this geometry, forces in every member, this is tension type of force and this is compression type of force. So, forces in the member, in every member, can be calculated only with the help of equilibrium equation if our truss has this type of geometry means triangular type of symmetry. Then we are able to find the value of member forces. All the member forces we can determine. And first type of forces are under the category of perfect stress on the basis of its analysis. On the basis of analysis, this triangulated geometry type of stresses are called as perfect stress and imperfect such stress, the number of member is exactly same. Number of member is exactly same by 2j minus 3, exactly same. And what are other category? Another category is imperfect stress. Number of member, if the number of member is not equal to this, if the member can be more, member can be more, or member can be less. I am showing you just an example of imperfect stress. Suppose this is the case. Look in this truss. We do not have triangulated type of geometry here. Because this force was not present over here. If it is present, then it will be perfect. So, by removing this member, it will be under the category of imperfect stress. And number of member will be one member will be lacking. You count the number of joint and find the number of member and compare it. You will see that one member is missing. So this is this type of truss are called as deficit truss. First type of truss. Okay. If this has another example, if this truss has this member, and apart from this, it has also this type, it has also this member. Then in this case, number of members are more. Required number of members are more as compared to 2j minus 3. So these are the examples of the imperfect truss. In reality, we are preferring this type of truss, but for calculation point of view, for analysis point of view, perfect truss, calculation for perfect truss is simple. These are indeterminate truss. First type of truss also called as indeterminate type of truss means we need some compatibility equations to solve all the member forces. Okay. Prior to start method of analysis, I would like to tell you the assumptions. I would like to tell you some assumptions which we will use in calculating the forces in the truss member. Two assumptions are important. First one is loads are acting at the joint only. What it means we can apply the load at these points only. We can apply any type of load, but that load must be at this joint. If the load is here, if the load is here, then it is stress, but we are neglecting that. Load transfer mechanism should be through the joints. First assumption. Assumption means we are assuming, we are considering the wrong thing. It can never be possible. Second one, assumption which you are going to make correct, and it is members are pin jointed. All members are pin jointed. What it means? Every joint in the truss are pin jointed. Every joint in the truss are the pin jointed. This is also practically, it is also not true. Joints are either welded or riveted. Mostly we are using riveted joints. So these two assumption we will take while solving the member force in the truss. Based on these assumptions, we will start analysis. So far as your syllabus concerned, we have to study two methods for analysis. First one is method of joint, and second one is method of section. We have other method also. These are the numerical methods. We also have graphical methods. We also have another method, substitution method. We also have tension coefficient method. But our syllabus point of view, we will cover these only first two methods in this sessions. Look at here. This is a simple truss. Number of joint. How many number of joint are here? Number of joint J equals to 1, 2, 3, 4. Four joint. Number of member. How many number of members? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Required number of member for perfect is M. Required for perfect is kitna? How much? It is 2j minus 3. We know that it is 2j minus 3. So 2 into j is 4 minus 3 is equal to 5, and available number of members are 5. So the truss which is given is a perfect truss. So this is the first step before solving the before to start the calculation. You first check it out whether this given truss is the case of perfect truss or not. This truss can be used, this truss can be analyzed only with the help of equilibrium equation, means it does not need any compatibility equations. Method of joint, we are considering method of joint. With the help of this example, I will tell you the method, the steps of this method. So the steps for this method are number one find support reactions. Support reactions. Find support reactions. Within bracket, if we do not have, we do not have a joint where two members connect. Okay. Second, okay, for this we will solve one question, then I will explain this. Second one, a step, make FBD, make FBD at all joints, make FBD at all joints, and then third, choose FBDs as per suitability to find the member forces with the help of equilibrium equation. Choose FBD and apply equilibrium and apply equilibrium equations. These are three steps of method of joints. These are three steps to be followed in method of joints. So, step number one, find support reaction. Here we need to find the support reaction. Support reactions will be calculated with the help of equilibrium equation. What are the equilibrium equation? We know very well, sigma f x 0, sigma f y 0, sigma m z equal to 0. So, with the help of equilibrium equation, we will get R a plus R b. Okay. Sigma f y is equal to 0. By applying sigma f y equal to 0, I am writing this. What will be the value? R a plus R b, and perpendicular downward is 1. So, this is equation number 1. And sigma m about this point A equal to 0, we will get another equation in terms of R A and R B. At this point, moment of R A about this will be 0, no need to write, 1 kilonewton force, so moment will be 1 and perpendicular distance is 5, it is clockwise. If I am taking clockwise as positive, so write positive, and another is RB into perpendicular distance is 7.5, okay, and the direction of moment for this force will be which one? Anticlockwise, that why minus sign has been taken. So, and no other force is left. So, equate it as 0. Value of RB can be calculated 5 divided by it is a it's a 5 divided by 7.5 means how much value? 0.33 point RB 0.667. Okay. By putting this, you will get the value of R A. You will get the value of R A. One minus this one, 0.667 means 0.333. So first is find the value of R A and R B. Second step is make F B D. Second one step is make F B D. Okay. So so, value of R is calculated as 0.333, and value of R B 0.667, that we have calculated. Our next step is our next step is to find the member forces. Okay. Our next step is make FBT. So make FBT for all joint, but we will consider the FBD one by one. Okay, so FBD at point, FBD at joint, at joint A. Okay, consider the force in members as tensile. Okay, so this one force you write it as FAC, write it as FAC, write it as FAD, FAD. Okay, in question 1, since member 1 is here, 1 is mentioned, so you can write it as F1 also, you can write as F1 also, but it is preferable that you follow this fine convention. Initially you consider all the forces as tensile force in this manner, in this manner. Okay, if member force are compressive, then what will be the answer? Answer will be negative. After calculating, we will get the negative value. So FBD, what will be the FBD? FBD, consider this FBD. So we will have this one F, you can write it as either F1 or this one. So I am writing as F1, and reaction value, this one is 0.333. okay, and this one, this is F2. Two unknowns, we resolve the forces, this one F1 forces in this direction and in this direction. Okay, you know this value, this value 30, so this 60 degree, so F1 cos 60, on this one is F1 sin 60, apply equilibrium equation and find the value of the F1 and F2. After applying the equilibrium equation, you will get value of F1 as -0.666 unit will be in kilonewton, and F2 is 0.5767 kilonewton plus. Positive sign indicates that it is tensile, and negative sign indicates that it's a compressive. After calculating these two values, we need to mention here, since force in AC, AC means F1 has been calculated as minus sign, with minus sign, that's why the assumed direction is wrong, and that's why in final figure we will mention this, and we will write as 0.666, and F2 is was positive, so it is a 0.575767. This is the value, kilonewton. Okay. Reaction value we already calculated, 0.333. Okay. After this, we will consider this joint, means FBD, FBD at joint, B, FBD at joint B. Same manner, we will follow the same manner. Okay, consider this FBD, this part of BD, RB is known to us, it is 0.667. So we will have this type of, force system, FBC, you here it is FBC is F4, and this is FBD, it is here F5. Two unknown forces are here. Okay, that angle we know very well, apply the equilibrium equation sigma fx 0, sigma fy 0 and find the value of f 4 and f 5. After applying the equilibrium equation sigma fy 0, sigma fx 0, you will get this value f 4 as minus 1.334. Minus sign shows that its nature will be compressive. If nature will be compressive. And f 4 is this one, so this sign, this will be reverse, means f 4 compressive means this one direction, this direction will be shown here, and the value 1.33 f 4 and similarly f 5 will be calculated and its value is plus 1.55, so it is 1.155 with the help of equilibrium equations. Okay, which one member is missing? This one. Okay, so consider tensile force, as I told you earlier. So next step will be take FBD at joint D. So what will be the FBD? Perpendicular downward 1 kilonewton. 1 kilonewton is here, 1 kilonewton force is here, this one direction is 0.5767. okay, this one force we have calculated the value 1.155. okay, one more for this one force FDC, you can write it as F3. At this joint, 4 forces are acting, only one unknown. Resolve these forces into this direction, in this direction, because you know the value of this value of inclination theta, this one component, it will be FDC sin theta is sin 60, this one FDC into cos 30. Apply the equilibrium equation, and find the value of F3. F3 value can be found out by positive sign 1.1547. Since positive value is there, so assume direction it is correct, means we will write here as 1.155. Okay. So this is the procedure to calculate the member forces in perfect truss. Okay, perfect truss. So in next class we will do some more questions. You can try by yourself for calculation of member forces in this truss. You can try for this also. Same procedure will be here. Okay, here this one force, I have mentioned the forces, so neglect the forces, answer is given directly, neglect the forces and find the value of the member forces, right. So thank you all for listening my today's lectures.